I don't know if they do now. But in any case, so we had to go the private route.
Mm-mm.
So the Northwind development started to talk to financing entities, and we put the financing together.
Mm-mm.
And so we are now at the source of the transmission line.
So
as opposed
who
to the
is running the Bungie windmills?
Northwind. Yeah.
Is a private company.
Is a private company.
Yes, yeah. And it has no contract with the local government.
Well, it has a contract with the local electrical distribution cooperative, Ilocos Norte Electrical Cooperative, so that the power goes directly to INEC and to be distributed to the province. Before, the usual practice is that for all the power to be that is generated to go into the national grid.
Yes.
But we found some savings. So sabi ko, sayang naman yung savings na yan. Kung we'll just sell it to the national grid, those savings would be lost.
Mm-hmm.
So let's give the power, when it's available, directly mm-hmm. to INEC, directly to the province. That way we can avail of those. Mm-hmm. That it's about 4 to 5 centavos savings per kilowatt hour, which is not insignificant.
That's pretty good.
Sure.
Actually, even the whole commercial of it, I mean, you know, seeing you doing that. Now, something else, peace and order was a question that was tweeted in yesterday, and this is very interesting. Okay, Mayor Torralba apparently is under, is supporting you.
Yes, yes.
And he's apparently linked to the killing of a security of a rival, if I remember correctly. This was the tweet.
Yes.
All right. And yet, Mayor Torralba was the host of Manny Villar in Ilocos Norte. What's your take on that?
Well, there was an incident years ago where there was shooting incident. Where people, basically people at the fiesta shot at one another.
Okay.
And the upshot of it was one of the security of his opponents were killed.
Okay.
So I guess that case is pending and ongoing. So.
Mm-hmm. But you still support him?
Oh yes, yes. Uh-huh. He has been one of our allies for a very long time, and he was a mayor when I was governor for. I think he's finishing his third term now. So he came in on my second term.
Mm-mm.
So, you know, of course we tried to, he was one of the mayors that was working under me. So,
but you didn't investigate the reason behind the killing.
I think it was just one of those drunken brawls, really.
People, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was the end of the fiesta. People were a bit hyper. They confronted one another.
Yeah.
Shots were fired. We don't quite know who shot whom.
Okay.
And the upshot was somebody was. I think there were a couple of people who were wounded,
mm-mm.
and one eventually died.
Okay.
So, but that's being that case is ongoing.
All right. Okay. Our fans and followers on Facebook and Twitter have more questions for you, Justin. Bubble Wink asks, "Do you have an ambition to become president?"
Well, this question keeps coming up.
Don't be shy.
But the fact of the matter is, this is not part of some grand plan for me to run for president at some point.
But you think you're qualified to be president?
You know, that's a tough question for the simple reason that I have a different view on the presidency than most people
have. Like what? It's destiny.
For the simple reason that I saw the other side of the presidency.
Yeah.
People generally see the president, you know, they see the president, all the pomp and circumstance and the work that the president can do and the influence and power that the president wields.
Yeah.
And that's one side.
Yeah, and you saw that yourself firsthand.
Yes, so do most people, because that's the public face of the presidency. But I've seen the private face of the presidency, and it's a tough job.
Uh-uh.
I mean, if you're not having a tough time, if you're not losing a great deal of sleep, if you're not stressed out,
mm-mm.
if you're not working very, very, mm-mm. very hard, 16 hours a day, every single day of the week, then you're not doing it right.
Okay.
So it's not something for me. I suppose I have a slightly ambivalent view on the presidency, not the same as others.
Well, I read the Philippine Tatler, where you're the cover,
I found out
it says here you're a reluctant politician.
Well, I am in many ways, because when my father was president, I mean, like any father, I suppose, he was very keen that I would follow in his footsteps or that I'd go into politics. And I resisted with every in every way that I could.
Okay.
For the simple reason that I thought that he was so dominant in the political arena that I would never make a name for myself. And then the work was, you know, we've been in politics. I always say, when people ask me, since when were you in politics? Yes. I say, since when I was born.
Okay, I want to ask you, but you've got to answer quickly because there are 10 million questions
here.
So when you were a teenager, I mean, given the fact that you grew up with so much power, what were, I mean, did you drink too much? No? I'm just curious.
Me?
Well, did you ever try drugs?
Well, when I was in school, there was always people were always rolling
marijuana.
Yeah, so when I was in Oxford, but I'm an asthmatic, so I can't smoke anything.
So you've never tried marijuana?
I tried it, but it gave me such an attack that I said, forget it. It's simply not for me.
Okay.
So those things, but again, you said with so much power, I didn't have any power. My father was president, not me. So I was just a son. Maybe if you were a governor, you had a little power in the province. But beyond that, I don't see what power I wielded.
Okay, so you mentioned you studied in Oxford, and one of the things that I noticed is you sent your three sons to London for schooling. And considering you say you feel for the country, you see, you're hopeful about the Philippines. Why send your children abroad? Aren't the schools here good enough?
Unfortunately, the schools are here are unfortunately the public schools here are not good enough. It's one of my advocacies because if we notice, we look at the public spending on education, it used to be an average of about 50% in my father's time. It has now decreased to 16%.
So your kids are in a public school in London?
They're with a corresponding decline in quality of education, and also, you know, they're kids. They have to grow up in an atmosphere where they're allowed to learn. And if they were here, all they would hear would be the Marcos issue, the this, and all of those things. I don't think that it would be a healthy environment for them to grow up in. And so they're very Filipino.
So, walang yaya doon, mayaya ba sila?
I'm mula naman 2 years old. Walang yaya yung mga.
Walang yaya yun.
No, we don't believe in yayas.
Wala.
No, we're not.
Hindi ka nagyaya?
After 2 years old, the yaya was there was no more yaya for the boys.
Oh, very good.
Because there's no point to it.
Okay.
They don't need them anymore.
Rod Magaro asks, "What's your take on charter change? Briefly, okay."
My take on charter change is I really do believe that there are amendments that need to be examined.
Like what? Give me one.
Well, for example, term limits. For example, the actual length of term is 3 years. Maybe it's a little too quick. But the point
for local office, you mean?
For local office.
For mayors, congressmen.
Yeah. Yes. And even the multi-party system has come into question.
Yeah.
There are many aspects of it that I think have become obsolete or are no longer relevant to the political conditions that we're in. But
what about turncoatism?
Turncoat, that again, the multi-party system is
encourages that.
It shouldn't. There is something wrong when there is no political cost to someone jumping ship from one party to another.
Okay. What about political dynasty?
Again, I'm glad you asked that, because there's mention of political dynasty, but you put in a three term limit. But what happens? They let their wife run, the son run, and then they come back.
Yeah.
So what happened to your anti-dynasty thing? It's ineffective. So let's examine and see. If you really want to have some kind of anti-dynasty rule, then this one is not working. Mm-hmm. I also believe there's a very good anti-dynasty system. It's called an election.